All right, today, so we're here at Tolosa Winery in beautiful Edna Valley. Let's go on inside and check this place out.
Hi, my name's Jay Bond. I run the Bond Real Estate. I made it my mission to showcase all the eateries, bars, wineries, and everything else the Slow has to offer. Join me for the Slow Spotlight.
Here with Colette Van Gerwen. She's the estate manager here at Tolosa Winery. Colette, thank you so much for having us.
Thank you.
Really appreciate it. So, you know, I got a couple questions for you. I just wanted to find out and kind of hear from you. You know, where did the name Tolosa come from?
So, Tolosa is named after Mission San Luis Obispo de Tolosa. Mm-hmm. And the mission is this area's most famous landmark, but over 200 years ago, the friars planted the first vineyards in the county. So today, Tolosa is carrying on their legacy of winemaking.
Okay, amazing, amazing.
Yeah.
And so, you know, being in this tasting room, I frequent here pretty regularly, as you know. So I wanted to hear from you, you know, what is probably the most popular wine that people are requesting to taste here?
Yes, that's a great question. So we are most well known for Pinot Noir.
Mm-hmm.
And our flagship, Primera, is
yes.
the most popular wine.
That's my favorite
yes.
as well. So. Delicious wine. So why don't you tell us a little bit about some of the events taking place here. I know you guys have quite a few going on throughout the year. Is there anything upcoming or anything exciting you want to talk about? Or?
Yeah, we have a variety of events. Mm-hmm. Some are exclusive to our 1772 Wine Club members and Primera Tolosa members. Others are open to the public. We have beautiful winemaker dinners that are paired with our wines, featuring a local chef. We also have tastings on the terrace mm-hmm. where we pair Tolosa wines with decadent small bites.
Well, thank you so much. I'm going to polish this taste, but I'd love to get Try behind it. The scenes and kind of see what you guys are working on. Is that cool?
Absolutely.
Amazing.
Yes.
So behind the scenes here, Colette, why don't you tell us a little bit about this room and kind of what's going on back here?
Sure. So you are in the Barrel Loft, and this room, we offer a very unique experience. Mm-hmm. You can taste the single vineyard here out of the barrel April through October.
Okay.
And so I have a splash of our single vineyard Solomon Hills Pinot Noir for you.
Oh, try. Amazing.
2017.
17, perfect.
Yes.
Right out of the barrel, folks. Okay. Well, it smells delicious already. It's amazing.
Yes. I agree.
I'm excited to see it be bottled and come to fruition. So, oh, this is delicious. Well, thank you so much
thank
for
you.
Taking me back here. This is fun.
Yes.
So, really appreciate it. Thank you again.
Thank you.
To be sitting with the man himself, the winemaker here, Mr. Frederick De La Vera. So Frederick, thank you so much for
thank
having
you, Jay.
Us. Absolutely.
My pleasure.
Oh, thank you for having us. It means a lot to me. So, you know, quick question, you know, why don't you kind of start out by telling us a little bit more about your unique transition. I know you came here to Tolosa from Napa. Do you want to kind of delve into what inspired that transition and how that's
sure,
been going for
sure.
you?
Sure, sure. Well, first, 21 years ago, I had a transition coming from France, obviously. to yes. California, uh-huh. and I spent 20 years in Napa, Sonoma, and I came here almost a year ago with Jean Hofliger, who's the mm-hmm. wine consultant for Tolosa, and we toured the vineyard, we tasted all the wines, and I got, you know, the opportunity to interview and got the Tolosa job offered, and we, you know, it's not only a job, it's I have a family, so it's mm-hmm. you look at the area where you're coming, where you're gonna end up. And you know, we thought it was great and for to raise a family here. So we just pulled the trigger, and I started at Tolosa July 2017.
Absolutely, and such a great area to live
in. It is, no regrets. I don't regret the move at all.
Raise a family, etc. Yeah. And my family made that transition from Texas here almost 100 years ago, so I know exactly what that mindset, you know, was behind that move. So Fredrik, why don't you tell everyone a little bit about your philosophy on some of the single vineyard wines as well as Primera?
Well, first of all, I want to say I'm spoiled at Tolosa because I have that collection of single vineyards of Pinot Noir and Chardonnay. Mm-hmm. And they go from up north, Petaluma Gap, IVA, down to, in the south, the Santa Rita Hills. So basically the idea, to me, what I want to show, we have six different Pinot single vineyards, and we have two Chardonnays, and then I'll talk about Primera after, but those single vineyards, we chose them because they all have a specificity and a unique character. So I just want to just let the vineyard talk. You know, because when people, usually we taste them side by side, and so six different Pinot side by side, they don't taste the same. Why? Because they grow on a different soil, and the climatology is a little bit different in every single of those vineyards. So yeah, there's some common things. The main one being all those vineyards are close to from the coast, mm-hmm. so they get that marine influence, but it's to some degrees. Some are a little slightly warmer than others, and then, as I said, the difference in soil and the difference in elevation and exposure gives you different characteristics in all of those different wines.
Very true, and it's very distinct in the mm-hmm. flavors of the wine, and I taste them quite often here. I'm a good testament to that.
And Primera, Primera is the flagship for Tolosa. Primera is 100% Edna Valley, so estate fruit. So the idea, what I call Primera the tête de cuvée. The idea is like we have all those great lots of Pinot in the house. So with our consultant, Jean Offliger, we go through every single lot, we grade those lots, then we take the A's and we taste every single barrel in those A blocks, and we grade the barrels. And Primera is born from the best barrels of the best blocks of Pinot Noir at Tolosa.
And it's an amazing bottle, that's for sure. And you touch base on something I think really important to this wine region, not just the little microclimates, but you know, some of the soil as well. You want to expand on that a little bit?
Yes, so there's two, I mean, the soil is where, it's kind of a, I don't know, a no-brainer thing, but the plant come from the soil, right?
Yes.
So here, we're at the frontier of volcanic soils, sedimentary soils, mm-hmm. and oceanic soils. So we have a patchwork of different soils, and you know, a plant that's going to grow on a sedimentary soil not going to have the same character than one growing on a seabed, mm-hmm. and so that helps bringing diversity to our wines.
Yes.
A lot of diversity,
mm-hmm, absolutely,
and complexity therefore in the wine.
Very true flavors, etc. Mm-hmm. And is there anything in particular? I know we touched base on a lot, which I think really encompasses the overall you know, differences in Edna Valley wines. Is there anything else you want to touch base on to kind of add to that? Or?
Well, I think, you know, Edna Valley is very blessed in terms of wine potential, and we have the phenomenal weather, we have great soils, and we work hard to show what Edna Valley can make. And I think we're starting to get the recognitions from the critics. You know, the Wine Advocate gave us a fair amount of good scores, above 90 points for the 16 vintage. And we're just gonna keep building off of that.
Yes, absolutely, absolutely.
And put Edna Valley on the map of the wine world.
I know, making
headway.
That's
the goal.
That's for sure. Well, Fredrik, I can't thank you enough for taking the time today to meet with us, kind of tell your story and a little bit more about, you know, Tolosa and what makes the wines here so special. So
my pleasure, Jay. Thank you very much for coming over.